two places.
Yes, one south of Appalachia Parkway, one north of Perry Port. Because we're a big community.
Can I just ask you, what's the Appalachia Parkway bias? I wanted to say Barnaby.
That would be south of Appalachia Parkway.
All Appalachia Parkway.
It's on the southern side.
It's addressed as Appalachia Parkway.
It is on the southern side.
All right, TikTok, Rachel. Seriously. So, all right, obviously, we've already made some of my favorites.
Because obviously, like, no visit should be without going to Palm Springs or Cascade Park, for that matter.
You're allowed to enjoy yourself.
That's good, that's good. And, you know, north, I mean, a little trip up to Thomasville, Georgia is a good idea.
Again, not in Thomasville.
Okay, so my point is, the Tallahassee Twitterverse is encompassing of a much larger area outside of the ground.
I'm sorry, I believe we're running.
Wait, hang on a second, we have a question from the audience over here. We have a question from the audience. You're ignoring our supporters. Sir, please proceed.
What happened to Bradley?
Wow.
Geographically, it's within the Bermuda Triangle that is
north of Perry Forest Park.
Yeah, I like this guy. Can he replace Tish?
Yeah.
I thought it was like east, like it's still in this swamp.
It's north of Perry Forest.
They'll be serving Bradley sausage in the Tallahassee Twitter mayor's.
Appalachia Parkway still maintaining the inside of the Leon County general area would be Doak Campbell Stadium.
I think the main thing we've got to do is
anyone who wants us to go to Bradley's to have sausage, I'm
there. All right, for the next question, hopefully less pain for everybody.
That was tough.
Brad, Deep Brewing Company is naming a craft beer after you. What is it called?
The greatest beer ever made. The best thing that will ever touch your lips.
Oh, it has like a sub.
Exactly. It will be a beer that you want to fall in love with.
There's a lot of fine print on the label.
Marry and divorce all in one sip.
Rachel.
Well, whatever Greg Tisch said, that like alphabet soup might as well end the story.
There you go. Danny?
It's clearly Aller Ale. I mean,
that
whoa, thank you. One person in the audience.
Woo!
Yes.
Wait, one more to go. Rachel, your first mayoral resolution on Twitter will commemorate what person or event?
Oh, well, Prince of Iraq, of course. We'll have to commemorate his birthday because really what would Tallahassee be about that historical marker of Prince
of Iraq?
Right?
Danny?
Okay, so you're asking what my first moves would be as mayor?
Your first mayoral resolution. You're going to have like one of those proclamation things and a ceremony and all those therefores.
I have five.
Oh,
so I'm going to actually need an extension on time here for our time. Number one, make the day before every FSU game a paid holiday for anyone with a 323 code. All Tallahassee Mexican restaurants offer dollar tacos 24/7, 365.
Wow,
that was good, right?
That's two-thirds of the audience.
Number two, require all local breweries, including Deep, to have happy hour every day for Tallahassee residents. All the time. Two for one. Maybe three for one.
Tallahassee
three for
Twitter.
One? Maybe three for
I'm
one?
Sorry, I need an amendment here. From the Tallahassee Twitter.
Number four, recalibrate so that they work. Number five, ban Jay Cutler from ever visiting Tallahassee because I hate Jay Cutler. That's okay. That's very random, I know. But I just
I appreciate my candidates' very long responses on these questions. But I would have to say that I would not have a day after that scummy, smelly Frenchman, Prince Murat. And even though he didn't come up with this entire thing today, he was not a good person, and we should not recognize good or bad people in this city. Danny, I agree with everything you say except for the tacos. I believe that Barnaby should have dollar pizzas every day for the last
All right, last but not least, there's a visual for this one. Several times in our debate, the topic of our traffic has come up and our drivers. And in many other communities besides Tallahassee, there's this thing by the steering wheel that those drivers use to indicate to start. If you need an
clear the windshield.
Wiper and a turn signal out of a 1994. Let me finish, ma'am. I appreciate
you. Cutting off the moderator. Bold moves. Bold
my candidates again will not let me finish my answer.
I don't think Greg is respecting his female moderator. What's up with that?
I have never disrespected this woman.
Anyway,
this is something that Tallahassee drivers don't use and don't know how to use. But it is called a turn signal and windshield wipers and lights. And to use all three of those on a rainy day is a sight not seen in Tallahassee.
No, definitely not. And then the roundabout, you're gonna die.
Are we taking questions from the audience?
Any questions, audience? Audience questions? We have no audience. So.
Because these people drinking over there do not take time out to pay attention.
The issue of candidate Pienta's residency, has that come up at all?
Wow.
I've seen Twitterverse.
Wow. You know, she is, sure her name is McCullough Ryder, and I said early on in this, she should not be in this race at all. We should just disqualify her right now.
Well, I still want her Maddox issue come up.
But I allowed it because she worked with my mom, and my mom likes her a lot.
Cheers to Kathy Allen.
And that's how Tallahassee works.
She actually solicited my mom's vote, and my mom gave it to her, and I'm quite upset with her, actually.
I interviewed a few people about Danny on the way here, including his childhood baby as well, from McCullough.
I'm a McCullough native.
Sorry, he doesn't live there anymore, but he's a native. His origins are in McCullough, deep roots in the area.
I'm born in Nashville, Tennessee, and raised in Tallahassee. Went to elementary school. I went to elementary school at Timberlane Elementary School. I went to middle school at Rock. I went to high school at Lincoln. And I went to Tallahassee Community College. So that greatly vote for me because I'm the only true Tallahassean in this race.
Can we just comment real quick on his love for the Padres? They're like 12-20, like a month into the season. They're already out of the playoffs. What's going on, man?
Perhaps if you voted for me, I could make the Padres of San Diego a little better.
Well, just a little bit of housekeeping. Being the strict organization that says we really don't know when voting ends exactly. I think Twitter says one day, but what a Twitter day is, I'm not sure. But go to PrinceNarrotTLH, at PrinceNarrotTLH, to vote for your favorite candidate.
It's on Twitter, people.
Hot towels for everybody if you vote for
them. And
allergy
for America's Second Harvest.